I'd rather you torture me with the torture instrument of torture before I let my people see me eat your pork. It also says that they went into the temple, was having sex in the temple. They was bringing unsacred things in the temple. And it's been passed down to the church today. Because the church today do the same thing those people was doing, the European people over there was doing in Jesus' time. The church is doing it now. And the church is an ecclesia, a Greek name for called out one. Called out from what? From being a part of God, from being the chosen ones, from being the people of God, or called out from God to follow another God? Yes. Santa is one of them. They always wanted Zeus. His name is mentioned in the book of Maccabees. Zeus is a god that they worship. Zeus wanted to sit in the place where Jesus is said to have sat and will seat, will be seated. Matter of fact, there's two mounts in Jerusalem. He wanted to sit in Jerusalem. Then there's another mount, Mount Gerizim. G-E-R-I-Z-I-M. It's in your same Bible. This book says that Zeus wanted to sit on there. Why would they take these books out the Bible and give you just the Bible, but don't tell you Zeus wanted to take over Jerusalem at one point? That's because they're Rome. They serve Zeus. They want those people, us people, the people sold into slavery, to worship Zeus instead of Yahweh. That's why God says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, you don't even know you're serving another God. Just on Jesus alone, not Christ. Jesus is a Greek word. Jesus is a rendition of a Hebrew name, Yeshua. Why not leave the man's name Yeshua? This is in your, this is in the world's Bible, the dictionary. This your Bible. This your words. Put their words back on them. Don't just keep taking their words because they can make words up. They put new words in the dictionary every day. Is they going to put religion wink? Is they going to put religion wink? Is they going to put somebody stole your religion? We know it from the beginning of time, but we're too afraid to talk about it. Back to Santa. All right. So now, December 25th comes around. These people got us to eat pork, got us to worship other gods, got us to say and do things in church that we ain't supposed to say and do. Got us going to seminary school, cemetery school, and every other school but the school of the Holy Spirit. Because that's where you get your real information from. That anointing ain't on your life. I don't care where you're going, who you think you're going, who Robert Oral. I love Robert Oral when he was little. I don't care whose school you go to. If that anointing of God ain't on you, and if Zeus is on you, and you got more of Zeus in you than you do Christ, it's not going to happen. Let me tell you something. You can do what you want to do. It's not going to work. It doesn't work. You not going to line up with the word of God. You manipulate your way through, fake your way through. But I'm trying to tell you something. It don't last. It don't last, people. That's why more than 3/4, 90%, I say, of Christians struggle. Especially black Christians. All for my white friends and my white family out there. It's the truth. Black Christians suffer the most. You look out in the world with every other religion, and they seem to be getting all, no, let me take that back. The ones who killing in the name of any God is not doing it right. You don't kill in the name of God. Although Yahweh had us out there killing people to take over land and territory, we had to conquer that way. The whole Bible talks about people fighting and battling, and just is oppression and battling slavery, oppression, battling slavery, oppression, battling slavery. That's what the Bible is. I thought Christ came to set us free. So obviously he did. But somebody knew that and said, well, since he came and said this, let's put it back like this. Yes. Why? Because if Christ is the messenger and the Messiah, any other words after what he said really can be irrelevant, right? Not according to the Bible. We got to listen to everything Paul said. And then when you read some of Paul's stuff, and I can prove it to you, and you're going to say, how you going to prove it to me? Because Christ can't die two ways. What is you talking about, Miss Drew? It says in your Bible he died two ways. I ain't gonna tell you how. That's another topic. But y'all put it in the comments. Do whatever you have to do to remind me. I'll write it on a note that I'm gonna show you. The Bible says he died two ways. You can keep on believing what you want to believe. Get back to Santa. Now, if you do your research, Tammuz is mentioned in the Bible. And there's other books that mention Tammuz, Osiris, Iris, Abraham, everybody else. The Book of Jubilee, the Book of Jasher, the Book of Enoch. All these other books that's not in the Bible for some reason, but that's biblically sound. I even looked up the Apocrypha. Yes, that's part of the Bible. It tell you it's biblical doctrine. That's not true. You can believe what you want to believe. I'm starting to believe the truth. And my eyes spiritually are being opened. My ears are open. You cannot have a Bible, a book called the Apocrypha that should be in the Bible, and then the Bible, the world's Bible, the dictionary tell you it's false doctrine. I'm not believing it no more. Sit down with me, have a round table. The Bible says study to show yourself approved. You think the Pope study that Bible right now and can sit down and have a biblical conversation when he's still talking about Jesus is a poor baby in a manger? And you supposed to be poor and broke like him, and his heart go out to all the poor broke people out in the world? When he rich? When the entity of the Pope is rich? Okay. So, Tammuz. Birthday is supposed to be the same day as Jesus. Go figure. Do your research. It's somewhere in between the 21st and the 25th. And if you think this is the day Jesus was born, I could take it to the Bible again. That is two different accounts. One says he's after the order of Melchizedek. The other one said he showed up as a baby. The book of Isaiah said a child is given unto us. When you're a child of God, does it mean you a baby? We gonna get into that. Anyway, these people, Osiris, Horus, Tammuz, Isis, she's the fertility, Ishtar, Ishtar, the fertility god, the Easter god, the one who was dipping her blood in her eggs in the blood. So your kids now, every Easter, they dip eggs in dye color. It'd be gross to dip it in blood, right? But that's what she did, and that's what they doing it after, okay? Do your research. Tammuz, he was some kind of king or whatever. But I don't know if it was Abraham, because even in the Bible says when Melchizedek met up with Abraham, Abraham just came back from the slaughter of the kings, the war of the kings. Abraham was out there kicking some ass. And one account says Abraham cut the body up and threw it throughout the land. But they ain't gonna tell you that. They wanna tell you that his brother or somebody cut up his body. No, Abraham was out there fighting the war. If it says it in the Bible, I read it in Hebrews 7. You can read it in Hebrews 7. Hebrews. Wasn't there a nation called the Hebrews, Israelites? Where is the Hebrew Israelites at? If the book is in the Bible, where the people at? If the book of Romans is in the Bible and you still got the Roman Pope, where is the yes. Now you get the picture, right? Absolutely. They should have took the whole damn book out the Bible. How you gonna leave a book to the Hebrews in there but then get rid of the Hebrew people and leave the Hebrew book in the Bible? It don't make no sense. And we got to stop believing everything they tell us. But they've been telling us since Christ died 2,000 years ago. And we still want to believe it. It's not their fault. Okay. So, over there in Egypt, you have the sun god and all these other gods. And just hear me out. Just like Zeus and Ra and Pharaohs, everybody had a name for God and his people. That's why God tell us not to covet, not to be envious, not to even bother with that stuff. Because there was some jealous people, still some jealous people in this world today. The evergreen tree came from Egypt. in the first